What a crazy turn of event for the vlog. This is a cold startup of a 1995 R33 GTR V-Spec. Yeah, I know, it's not really that impressive, but that will change soon enough. So everybody, yesterday I took delivery of this 95 R33 GTR, and it's hasn't really sunk in yet. I mean, it kind of has. Opening up the garage door this morning was really awesome, honestly. It was like, oh my God, it is actually here. It wasn't a dream, it's real. So here she is, guys. I know I didn't show you guys kind of too much of her in the last video because, well, I kind of just wanted to enjoy the car, and trust me, there's gonna be so many videos of this that you are gonna see plenty of the car. But this is in its kind of early stage right now, and it is mostly stock. We have the exhaust on the back. I'll show you the set of intakes as far as the motor is concerned, and besides that, she is pretty much stock, even on the interior. Now, I've had a chance to kind of look over the car now. I did see it obviously before I bought it, but you never quite get to see as much as when you actually have it at your house and, you know, actually get to look at it. So now, some of the stuff in this video I'm going to point out is basically all of the stuff that is wrong with my GTR that needs to be fixed. Now, with any Nissan Skyline you're talking about, or you know how well it is off, I think all Skylines have some problems with them, and that's just how Skylines are. People need to understand that when buying these cars, is even the cleanest, most well-maintained Skylines, stuff can still go wrong, and like with this particular example, it just needs a little bit of love. Nothing majorly wrong with it, but there is some things that it does need, so I'm gonna show you guys that today. So I've already been doing, honestly, some stuff to the car. So the first thing wrong with it is that it does not have a radio. It did come with a radio. Let's see if we can find it over here. Where did I put it? Here's the radio that it came with. So, let's see if we can get out in the light here a little bit. It is kind of early in the morning this morning. So this is the radio that it came with. It has a mini disc player. I don't know if you guys were around during the whole mini disc thing, but I've never seen a mini disc player in a car before. However, this doesn't work at all. It wasn't even connected. I already took the dash apart and got rid of this, took it out. So it is gonna need a new radio, which I will work on very soon. On the exterior, the car is in fairly good shape. This is the original paint on this car. It has some scratches. I don't even know how well you guys can really see it on camera. For the most part, nothing serious. I'd say the biggest thing probably is in the back here, right here. This here is probably one of the bigger marks on it. Go around this side. Overall, it's in really good shape for being the original paint color. You can see it looks like somebody may have hit something with a door on the side here. And there's a little bit of a, I don't know if you can see this. This is not a smudge. This is actually kind of like the clear coat. I don't know how well you guys can see it. There you go, you can kind of see it. So besides a little bit of imperfections, there's not too much wrong with the car, and overall, it's in pretty good shape. Now, this is a decently rare color, a gray metallic. I forget the exact, like, paint color. Something gray metallic. So it is a little bit rare of a paint color for an R33. You see a lot of them in silver, you see a lot of them in white. So that kind of makes this car a little bit more special that it is this rare paint color. I believe, let me see, I believe they only made like 1,100 of these in this color. Don't quote me on that, I have to check GTR registry again, but something like around 1,100 of these in this color. The last kind of thing on the exterior that isn't so great is these wheels. I mean, these wheels are okay. They're not terrible. They're 17s. They're kind of small for a GTR, or I should say an R33 in general. R33s really need at a minimum 18s, if not 19s. I haven't decided yet what I'm gonna go with as far as that's concerned, but either way, it needs bigger wheels and it needs new tires, because these tires, I don't know how old they are, but they're really old. I don't know how well you guys can really see this on camera. Apparently not really so, because it doesn't want to cooperate, but the tires are fairly dry rotted. So it kind of, I don't really want to take it too far because the tires are in such bad shape. And not only that, but we still need our registration and get insurance on it and everything like that, which I'll be doing very soon. We come back around this side here. Let's open up this door. Let's pop the trunk for the other thing that is wrong in the trunk here. So we're going to pull. Same switch as the R32. So in here, the trunk, I don't even know if I can do this with one hand. I'm gonna try. Lift it up by the wing. You guys can't tell, but if I drop this, like, it's literally just gonna fall. The trunk is very heavy. The shocks are completely out of gas. They do need to be replaced because they don't hold this trunk up at all. And it is literally like, it's literally like a guillotine, and it will just chop your fingers off. So that's been the hardest thing, honestly, I've tried to find so far, is those shocks. If anybody knows where I can get replacement shocks for that, let me know, because I've searched, I found a couple used sets. I don't really want to buy used ones. I want an OEM or close to it replacement. So if you know, leave a comment in the section below where I can get some shocks. So we'll go back over here and we will pop the hood. Walk around front here. Doors are very heavy. So let me put you guys on the tripod and I'll show you a little bit what's up under the engine bay hood. That makes no sense. All right, let's pop the hood here. Show you guys what we got going on. And well, hey, it's an RB26. It's kind of all you need to know, right? It's RB26. It's not an RB20. So that's honestly one of the big reasons why I kind of wanted a GTR. So I have it and I'm super psyched about it. Now, so everything in the engine bay is pretty tidy. Everything looks pretty good. The AC in this car, it doesn't blow very cold, so I'm going to have to recharge the AC. Luckily though, this being a 95, it has the new type of refrigerant, so that shouldn't be a big deal. I will probably actually do that later on today. It probably needs new spark plugs. I know that the fluids were all changed from the dealer that I got this from, so that's all kind of good and done. Besides that, this engine is pretty much stock. Let me grab you guys here. So yeah, here she is. It's pretty much a stock RB26, which is kind of exactly what I wanted. I know there's a lot of them out there, you know, that have mods done to already. But like I said, this one has literally these HKS intakes. And besides that, that's pretty much it. So we almost have like a blank slate to work with here, which is kind of what I wanted for the channel, because I want to bring you guys along with this process of not only modding it, but also fixing it up and kind of showing you the kind of real life stuff that happens with these imports in general. Not just this one, but all, not only Skylines, but all other imports. Where most of the time, people don't really realize that you get it from the importer or whoever else, but they do need some love, they do need some stuff. So that's kind of what I want to show you guys with this car. Moving forward, so I'm just kind of using this video to kind of just show you all the little-ish things that are wrong with this car that, you know, need to be addressed. Suspension-wise, this car is also bone stock, except for it does have, I don't know if you guys can see that, it has a set of HKS coilovers on it. I don't know if I can show you guys or not with my monster truck ride height. I don't think you're going to be able to see in there. No, it's going to be way too dark. They look fairly old. They're a little bit clunky, so eventually those will get replaced, but for now, they'll do it for now until we do end up replacing them. We are kind of sitting at a monster truck ride height, so obviously, you guys know me, that we're not going to stay like that for too long, because honestly, I can't stand it, but we'll get there, we'll get there. So this car is a V-spec, and it obviously has the Brembo brakes, like all GTRs do. It does have the 5-speed manual, obviously, because that's how they come. This car does have 136,000 kilometers on it, which is, what is that, like 84,000 miles, something like that. I don't know. You guys can convert it. Something like 80-something thousand miles. Also, coming around the side here, we do have this mirror tint. Look at that, straight-up mirror tint. That's obviously got to go because I will get pulled over very fast for that. We got it all over the back window here. So I will do a video of trying to remove this. Hopefully it's not that bad, but yeah, it's, we will get pulled over for it. So it will get retinted. And of course, for all the haters out there, we need some stickers. So overall, it's a very clean example of a car. No rust pretty much anywhere. A little bit on the underside on the suspension components, but besides that, like, the underneath looks very clean. If we ever get it on a lift, I will show you guys that. Could probably use an alignment, so I'll probably have an alignment done on her. That'll probably help a little bit, but that's pretty much all I want to say in this video. Now, I know some of you are probably wondering, why did you get rid of the R32 for an R33 besides the GTST versus GTR thing? But, you know, I will answer all of those questions and more on the channel. So, like I said, if you guys are new here and not subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button. We're going to be doing a ton of stuff with this car through the whole build process. Not only that, but we have some really cool cars coming up on the channel. I know in the next week or two, I have a built MR2 on the channel coming up. We're doing an Ariel Atom video that's going to be just ridiculous. Like I said, if you guys are new, make sure to hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate that. If you guys enjoyed the new car and enjoyed this video, hit that like button. I really appreciate that as well. It helps more than you know, trust me. And that's going to do it for this one, guys. Thank you guys for watching. And as usual, we will catch you all on the next video. Peace.